All right, the roll-up and second etch of our stones. So I have already completed my first etch, and so now I need to prepare it for the roll-up. So first I am going to follow the law, which is lithotene, asphaltum, and water. So first here you can see I put lithotene on my old image area. Remember I have a gum film or a gum stencil set up here. So what I'm trying to do is remove all the old grease using the lithotene. It will leave like a stain of the image there, and that's fine as long as I can see that most of that dark original greasy drawing material is gone. After that is done, then I use the asphaltum to establish a grease base, basically replacing my old grease with new grease on the stone. So the asphaltum I'm using is pretty thick, so I need to loosen that up a little bit with lithotene, and what I'm trying to do is make a nice brown film over my entire image area. So putting new fresh grease into that stencil. While that is drying, I'm gonna prep my leather roller with roll-up ink. So I'm laying out my slab, keeping that nice and even, and then bringing it over to the stone. So as soon as I get this wet, I wanna start rolling ink on it as quick as I possibly can so I don't get any water burn. So I start with the paper towel to pull up most of the excess gum arabic and any of that lingering asphaltum. And then I'm gonna use just a damp paper towel followed by the sponge, and I'm gonna start rolling ink on this as quickly as I can. Remember, I want this to be damp, not soaking wet, so I don't want any like water streaks running through my image. And I'm gonna start rolling up here. If there's leftover asphaltum, if it was drying on there for a while, don't worry, the roller will pick it up when I start rolling. So as I'm rolling here, nice even rolls, I'm rotating the roller every time I pull it back and rolling this up, and you can see that the image is slowly rolling up. If it rolls up super fast, like if it rolled up to the way I drew it right there, I probably didn't etch this quite hot enough. So I should be making several trips to the slab and back to the stone. And this image should roll up in a like two or three trips, maybe a little bit more. So if it takes forever to roll up, I probably etched it too hot. And if it rolls up really, really fast, then I probably didn't etch it hot enough. So I can adjust my etch in between the first etch and the second etch based off of how the image rolls up here. I tend to be a little bit careful with the first etch, maybe etch it a little bit lighter than I think it needs to etch so that I don't burn anything out from my original image. So I'm rolling it up here until it looks the way I drew it and I'm happy with it here. So then after that, I'm gonna fan the water dry. The ink does not have to dry, but the water on the stone needs to be dry. And once that is done, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna repeat all the steps of my first etch. And if this rolled up the way I wanted it to and in about the amount of time that I want it to, then I can repeat the same concentration of etch. If, like I said, if it rolled up really fast, I might need to etch it a little bit hotter. If it rolled up really, like it took a really, really long time to get it up to where I want it to be, then maybe I need to back off my etch a little bit. So you can see here me going back through all those steps that I did during the first etch. And I am, just gonna repeat those all the way through. Then at the end of the tight wipe, my image will be under a gum stencil again. And from there I can plan out and plot out my registration for my paper, which you will see in the next video, will be me setting that up on the stone.